I want to show you just one strategy that I've learned from ICT that will help you pass your prof farm challenges in like one step if you follow it right, because it has a very high win rate, almost 100, so you win most of the time. And I've used it to pass multiple prof farm accounts. And if you can see also here on the VIP, by the way, VIP is free for this month, so this coming month of July, let me say. So I'm now a funded trader with Equity Edge, as you see in the previous video, and this is the trade we took today. So let me break down this trade. This is a trade for day one of funding, though I stated here on the VIP clearly that people were supposed to use 0.2 lots, but I decided to obey that, and then I took my partial profits when I told people to take. And that was closing 0.1. Then the rest of the position, they ran up to TP. So that was it for like the trade. So now let me break it down. Let me get this. The path to. So this is what you have to do. You have to wait like when the market is going in an uptrend, like so. Let me put it here. So you have to wait when the market is going like this. So this zone is down, they be called demand zones, like this. This is a demand zone. This is another demand zone. So those are our demand zones. So when price comes to retest, let me say price has come to retest the demand zone like this, and then so this is what happens, what people think happens every time. They just think that the market will come here and then continue right up. So what I want you to wait for is, if this is a demand zone, wait for the price to weak or to go below where the demand zone ended. That is a more highly probability trade. So high probability trade. So if you wait for something like this, you will really get the most out of that trade, and you just target the previous high, which is going to be here. So yeah, with all that in mind, let me now take you and show you a chart example of the trade that we took today. So when you see me marking something like this, the circle, just know that's where liquidity was swept from. So let's go back here. If you see, this was our demand zone, this black candle from the body to the wick. This was our demand zone where we are supposed to buy from if we are to buy. So you can see that this is our demand zone, and the way I've drawn it, the bottom of the rectangle is where the zone ends. So price came, and actually, you see that candle that I was telling you about. If you have read about the power of three, you really know what you're talking about here. So that was the candle that did the sweep of liquidity. So after identifying that candle, you now wait for potential signs of going upwards. One, they can create for you an order block. So the order block would look something like this. Let me show you an example that I showed these people in the main channel about order blocks. So this is how the order block would look like, where you're supposed to enter from. I have a lot of those examples, and those are the trades I keep on catching. You see, their liquidity was swept. Then you go to those lower time frames, you get that order block. Same thing here, a demand zone, liquidity swept, and see, the market really runs in your direction. So yeah,
That's what I'm trying to say. So after that, you can now use your own confluences, whether bullish engulfing, order block, market structure shift. And then if you were sharp enough, you would have caught this trade from here, right here. See? Because of the order block they created here, or the bullish engulfing over this white candle. So you enter here, and then the market would give you more than a 10 hour, and most prop firms just need 8 hour for you to pass. So me, I normally wait for all this, and I wait for a clear direction. So you see, I wait for all this move. That's where I entered, because the move happened outside the session. So when we reached London session, I just knew they were going to continue the move. So ended up catching the market from here. Sorry about the noise, but